first one. It is not on the agenda yet. It will be. It's just this one. So this is a very small presentation which I'll use to demonstrate how the calculator works. So the example we have is a locality that was written as 0.6 kilometers north of Little Mermaid in Copenhagen, Denmark. It's a picture of the Little Mermaid. Of course, she went to China. She's back in Canada. Okay. So, I have been there. I have my GPS at the time. And I took coordinates of the Little Mermaid. And I found the Little Mermaid to be at this location, given in degrees, minutes, and seconds to the nearest second. So what we want to do is use the georeferencing calculator to determine where 0.6 kilometers north of the Little Mermaid is and what is the uncertainty associated with this entire description. Okay? So that's very much like the example that I just gave of 20 kilometers north of Nairobi, but the Little Mermaid is much smaller than Nairobi, so there should be much less uncertainty. And the 0.6 kilometers is quite specific. North is not so specific, just because it includes between the time. So, what I want to do is I'm going to use a combination of those documents to figure out what I'm supposed to do to georeference this. The first place I want to go is the georeferencing quick reference guide. Because I need to find out what it is that I'm supposed to do to the calculator. Similar to the one that I have. And I'm going to scroll the lines. Here it is. It's an offset and a heading. The example that's given is 50 miles west of Las Vegas, or 10 kilometers east of the Amama. So this is the locality type that I have, 0.6 kilometers north of the What it tells me to do is to select a calculation type that is coordinates and error. And what I'll do is enter the Latin long for the name of the place or the starting point. Remember, I have the latitude and longitude for the starting point of the Little Mermaid. That's my starting point. That's what Little Mermaid is. That's good. Next thing I'll do is to select a locality type, which is a distance at a heading. That's because I have a distance with its unit at a heading or direction from a named place. So that's this locality type. Then it goes on to tell me what to do if it says that it's by road or if it's not by road, or if there's more than one possibility and so on. So there's all kinds of detail here. Tells me what to do in special cases. I don't have a special case. I'm going to ignore all of this for the moment and go on. The extent should be the same as for named places, bounded area, or named places, which is another type of above on this document. What it says for named places and bounded area is to introduce the size, just the bounding box size around. In our case, the main place is the Little Mermaid, which is quite small. I've been there, I would estimate that she's no more than 3 meters across. So quite small. So now I'm going to go to the calculator and try to do this. In the presentation, the second slide shows all the entries that are supposed to be made to accomplish this. I'll do it here because it's easier than switching back and forth to the calculator and show you how we're doing this. So remember in the quick reference guide, it told us to select a calculation type of coordinates and error. I have done that. Actually, I will go to the calculator to show you something. When you open the calculator, it looks like this. Not haven't done anything yet. The first is basically helping you as a recipe, telling you step one is to choose a calculation type and use the button. There's almost nothing you can do wrong. Only two things you can do in the calculator at this point: choose your language and choose your calculation type. So we were told to choose the calculation type, coordinate and error. Having done so, I'm on to step two, which says choose the locality type and use the button. That's the only thing I can do besides change the calculation type and the language. I'll do that. They told me to select a distance at a heading. And you can see that the menu item here has an example for that type, so you know if it matches or not. 10 miles east by here from the base. I'll be at 0.6 kilometers north from the Murray flood type. Once I pick the type, then the calculator fills up with all the different things that you need to enter, everything that's important for that locality type. Now, our calculator looks a lot more like that one, except that I haven't filled out any of the data on the calculator so far. So this is the calculator after all of the data has been filled in and after the calculation has been made. Okay. Questions? Sources are gathered here. My coordinates were in degrees, minutes, and seconds. See it all? Here. Those are my original coordinates in degrees, minutes, and seconds. So I had to select that, just like here, on the calculator. Once I do that, just to show you what happens if you click the other ones, it changes the format and allows you to enter the coordinates in those other formats. I want degrees, minutes, and seconds. And the location was 51. Numbers are not. 51, 55, 41 degrees plus. 55, 41. And that was the north. You need to make sure that I put in the right direction. Longitude was 12, 35, 56 east. 12, 35, 56, and east. I've got the coordinates from a system that used the WGS84 data, World Geodetic System 1984. So if I can include that on the calculator. My coordinate precision, I would have the coordinates to the nearest second, if you recall. You need to select that from the calculator. Go back and see that. Right here, I have the nearest second. That's my coordinate precision. Now I'll proceed to this side and choose the direction. This is north. So all this says north. I'll show you the many, many different possible directions on this page. Including nearest degrees. But I have north. My offset distance was 0.6 kilometers. So I put in 0.6 there, and I choose kilometers as my distance units. precision was to the nearest tenth of a kilometer. That's the significant digit here on our measurement. So I'll include that right away. One tenth of a kilometer is my distance precision. So back here, just to make sure that that's what I said on this example, I did 0.6 and one tenth. The next thing is the extent of the named place. My named place is a little mermaid. And as I said, the base here of that rock is about 3 meters. So I'll use 3 meters as my extent. 3 meters in kilometers, if I don't know it, I can calculate it. Now here at the bottom of the calculator, I can see 3 meters is 0.003 kilometers, and enter that here. Measurement error is something that comes from a map, and I'm not using a map. So my measurement error is 0. So if I go back and look at this and review, it looks like I've done everything the same on my calculator as it is on here. All that's been filled in. But my calculator doesn't have any of this stuff. The way I get that is by clicking on the calculator button. So I've got everything I need to figure out where 0.6 kilometers north. I click on that, I get my answer. So this is the new location, it's not the same as the old location. And this is how much uncertainty there is associated. You can see that that's a fairly big number. It's almost half a kilometer, it's a little bit more than half a kilometer. What's the reason for that, based on what we just talked about? Why is it so big? Real reason is this direction and precision. Because we don't know what program it could have been northeast or northwest. That's why the end result is so uncertain. We can see what the effect is in the calculator if we do a slight change. Let's say that it was due north, exactly north. And so there shouldn't be any uncertainty due to the direction. See what that does to change the uncertainties. So I can do that by selecting the nearest degree and have the direction be 0. That's north. 0 is north. So now I've reduced my uncertainty due to the direction. I do a calculation again. And instead of more than half a kilometer, I'm down to just 139 meters. Tom?
Could you do the same thing, the same play, and just change datum to not recorded?
Yep.
You probably were going to do that?
Yep. Thank you for the suggestion. So I reduce some uncertainties here by saying that it's due north, or at least within 1 degree of north. Now, Tom's asking, what's the contribution to the datum? If I didn't know the datum, how bad would it be? And the answer to that is select the datum, not recorded, do the calculation again, and it adds a whole kilometer in that location. So knowing the datum in this case was the most important thing. So that's a quick preview of how the calculator works. And what I'd like to do is actually have you playing with the calculator and trying to replicate the results of some specific examples. So to do that, the first thing you want to do is to go to the georeferencing guidelines, the one that looks like this. Find this page. And then in the table of contents at the right on this page, under the appendices, there are calculation examples. Do you see that link? You click on that calculation examples link, it takes you down in this document to the very first of the examples. The calculation examples begin here. They're detailed examples, maximum error calculations, illustrating concepts, present in the document, not using the calculator. The idea is that it gives you an example. Here's an example that says, you want georeference, 35 degrees, 22 minutes, 24 seconds north, 119 degrees, 1 minute, 4 seconds west. And it tells you then exactly the things you need to do within the calculator. And finally, what your answer should be. And then after that, it tells you bit by bit or source by source what's contributing to that total uncertainty. So in this first example, you end up with a total uncertainty of 119 meters, and 79 meters of that come from not knowing the data. The other 40 meters come from the fact that it was only to the nearest second. So what you want to do is find this page in the documents, and then just go through these examples one by one until we run out of time, and see if you can replicate all of this and come up with this maximum error distance exactly as the calculator tells you. And do as many of those as you can. So, I'll start with the first one, just to keep you going. We're looking for a coordinate-only example. In the calculator, I want to choose a calculation type that is error-only. So the calculator should be... Let's go on here, go back to the calculator. And I'm going to do a different kind of calculation, which is an error-only calculation. Once I do that, the calculator removes all of the entries that I entered previously. They're actually stored in the calculator, so they won't be lost. But it clears the screen so that you know what the next step is. So I've chosen an error-only calculation. I believe that's what they told me to do. Go back here. Here, it's said to do an error-only calculation. Okay, so that's all I've done so far. Next thing to do is select the locality type, coordinates only. Calculator. Wait, select coordinates only. Now all the rest of the possibilities open up. And you can see that when I open the calculator again, all of the previous entries from the Little Mermaid example are still in there. That's so that you can reuse information in case you are starting at the same starting point. You have many different locations starting at the same starting point, saving you from entering all the information over and over again. So, back to the example. I've chosen a coordinates only locality type in the calculator. The next thing I'm supposed to do is say what the coordinate source was. In this case, it is assumed that this came out of a catalog. That was written as the locality in a specimen catalog. So, coordinate source was the locality description. Calculator, choose coordinate source. Please, it's only also the coordinate system is degrees, minutes, and seconds. You can see that degrees, minutes, and seconds. So I want to select that. It's already selected. After that, I need to enter the individual numbers that were given in the locality description. So 35, 22, 24, and all. original locality does not tell us the datum, and as this example tells us, we should choose the datum that's not recorded. Not recorded, it's always been selected. The next thing was recorded with precision, which it said was in units a second. The data is this. There is no measurement error because this is not in the map. The document tells us so. Measurement error is zero. Yes. And we can choose whatever distance units we want. Because the original description did not have any distance units. So I'll use meters, and I'll do the calculation. And it should be that my result matches that on the document. So if you remember, it said 119 meters of uncertainty, which this is to the nearest meter, at least 119 meters. So I got the same answer there. We look at the answer. The final coordinates should be 35.37333 and -119.017. So I was able to reproduce this result in the calculator. So what I want you to do is go to example 2, or even example 1, and see if you can also reproduce it if you haven't already. Or move on to example 2 and try to enter that calculation and see if you can come up with the same answer. So what I want to make sure of is that you can do that. And if you don't, if you don't understand why, raise your hand and we'll come around and figure out what it is that's wrong.